Barco reflects perfectly what I've seen at Critical Communications World. Hardware vendors getting more and more into software solutions. Today is a special day. Today is a day that I'm going to spend in Belgium. Our neighbors in the Netherlands, in the south. I already had two traffic jams, probably two more to come. And I love to make this trip. And I'm going to a company called Barco. I hear you saying, what is Barco? Barco is a company based in Belgium. It's listed on the stock market. And everybody should know the company, actually. As a matter of fact, the company delivers high-end cinema systems. So for those who have been in cinemas before, you probably have watched the movie through the eyes of Barco. Now I hear you say, what does that have to do with Critical Communications? Well, everything. Almost there. It's another 200 meters. And 20 kilometers, 4 hours drive, 4 traffic jams. I think it's a good day to visit Barco.
Wow, it's kind of an impressive building from the outside, but it's also impressive from the inside.
Hello, good morning. My name is Wolf, MCC Resources. Okay, thank you so much.
I will let you know that you have arrived.
Perfect, thank you.
I've never seen a headquarter of a company so modern, so fancy like the one here at Barco.
Are you in?
I'm in. Thank you so much. So we got Kurt and we got Matthias. Doing a guided tour here around the Barco facility.
At this big screen, you see different people playing together at the Antwerp Central Station. Different locations, so we call that collaboration.
What did we exactly see here?
So we saw a simulation of artists, people playing instruments in the train station of Antwerp. So all on different locations, and everybody was playing or doing their part of a certain sort in a perfect synchronized collaboration way, in a more, let's say, realistic way, we should say, in a more efficient way, to have smarter and faster decision making. But this is just an introduction. And then if it's okay, we can go now to the more real stuff in the real markets. Of course, we have different markets in a control room, dispatch room. So, but the needs are almost everywhere the same. Of course, there are differences. Think again about faster and smarter decision making. Every market has to suffer with big data, Internet of Things. So how can you integrate those things in your, let's say, system? How can you make those important things visual?
So Matthias, what we're looking right now is a scenario at an airport, right?
Yeah.
I can see over there, I can see the different runways.
We are looking to a common operational picture, which consists of all the sources the operator has to monitor. We are dealing with big data, with Internet of Things, an amount of sensors, devices who generate a piece of information they put available on the network, put available for the operator to monitor. We try as Barco to give you not only the best image quality, but also a video wall with certain intelligence, with certain integration that can help you to show the content that the operator needs to monitor.
Okay, that's interesting. An intelligent video wall.
We integrate on all systems, software the operator needs to work with. Those systems, we use actually their intelligence. Those systems generate a certain alarm, a certain trigger. We capture the trigger, and then we attach, let's say we attach a visual to it. So in case system A is having a certain alarm, then we launch, let's say, layout A, which gives you a visual, what is the alarm? And the whole idea, the whole goal of this is that the operator can react faster, better, so in the best way. So it's all about seconds in these markets. So we try to help the operator as much as possible. This is actually a system that the operator needs to monitor. We visualize it, and in case, let's say, a terrorist or a certain criminal is detected, that system will generate an alarm, and then we can maximize, make it more visual for the operator.
And all the cameras in that neighborhood can be activated.
That would be a very nice use case, so that automatically it triggers a layout with all the cameras in the neighborhood, so to, let's say, better react on it, to know where the person is going to, and then also to inform the police how to catch them in the fast
way. Because you can send that mugshot directly to the Tetra radio or to another radio, P25 radio, to the police officer on the street.
You probably have heard about this movie with Tom Cruise. It's called Minority Report, where Tom is moving all of these pictures away. And well, this is similar, actually. This multimedia board could be used in the crisis room very easily. Now, that is one thing. The other thing is that Barco is able to stream that view to the smartphone, for to the police officer on the street who is on duty, who wants to understand exactly what's happening in the crisis room. Now, in other words, that's the crisis room, this is the policeman on the street, and that's the picture in the control room. Are we going here?
Yeah, to the left.
We're going to... Ah. There's the magic door. The magic door. So this is the back. So it's only 60 centimeters, something like that.
Yeah. So here we are looking at a rear axis video wall. Why is it rear axis? So for maintenance and service reasons, you need some space behind. Let's say to change an input, to change a component of the wall. We also have a front access. Front access means you can put the wall a couple of centimeters away from the wall. So we don't need the space behind. You save a lot of space, let's say in total. Then you have front access modules, so you can lift the screen to do the maintenance and service from the front.
So it's all very effective. That's what you want to say.
Sometimes
actually,
place is the most crucial aspect. So in those situations, we can offer a really good front access video wall.
From the front end, it looks so easy, it's so simple. But when you see all of the technology that is involved in installing those video walls, it's kind of mind-blowing, is it? Belgium American Radio Corporation. What is exactly OffSpace? What does it do? What is the concept of OffSpace?
We already talked about integration, innovation for the video wall. We can bring the same advantages to actually the operator desk. So we had the last years we have been listening to the operators. We are aware of all their frustrations, what is annoying them, where they want to have more improvements. Think about desktop clutter, multiple keyboard and mouses to work with all the legacy systems. They are all on different networks, which brings a lot of complexity. We also think about ergonomics. So where the operator sits in his chair looking to the front of him, we bring all the sources, all the views, the PCs he has to work with right in front of him. We think about also the frustration of all the usernames and passwords. So we have single logons, we have follow me principle. So if you log in here on another desk, automatically your own layout, your own settings will follow you wherever you go. Keeping in mind all the security levels, Opspace brings you a lot of efficiency, brings you clean desk, ergonomics, and much more.
My visit at Barco has come to an end. It's 3:15 in the afternoon. I've spent more than 3 hours at this location, and I really can say that I have seen the latest and greatest in projection, control room management, screens, innovation, technology.
And I'm pretty sure that the company can play a very important role in the critical communications arena.
For now, that's enough Barco. Let's get a car and drive home.
Barco reflects perfectly what I've seen at Critical Communications World. Hardware vendors getting more and more into software solutions. I think that's the future. I think that's a very strong point if you go from a single provider of hardware solutions towards a complete integrator of critical communication solutions for control rooms, for example. For now, it's a drive home. Still 4 hours to go. 5 traffic jams planned. Probably by the time I'm at home, traffic jams are gone.
I just received a message from Chris Slash from Barco. Chris is the VP Operator Experience. He's also the Chief Operating Officer of Barco. He sent me this message.
Hi Gert-Jan, I hope you had a good visit at our beautiful Barco offices. And as you know, Barco has a very long tradition in delivering control rooms for mission critical installations. We're not only focusing on the large display walls, but these days we also give the customers total solutions. And this fits really well in our company mission of enabling bright outcomes for our customers. Hope to see you around next time.
All right, Chris, see you next time. Thank you very much for your message. Much appreciated. Let's move on.